Then the time the ENC was doing very well, so he had an idea that if you call it TOD, the audience also will demand some share of our equipment, and that's the reason it would be CED. So actually it's not CED actually.
The contact with the advisor, part of it, the major thing is bomb space. So if you have the bomb being dropped, like they're being dropped now, bomb is being dropped now, then you have to have a certain amount of equipment.
The Bombay Engineer Group, known as Bombay Sappers to the people in the army, is celebrating its 200 years of existence, that is from 1820 to 2020. On this auspicious occasion, there is a book, Post 71, talking about the valor and glory of Bombay Sappers, which is also being released. Today we have with us the author, stroke editor, stroke composer, stroke everything of that book, Bharadwaj. And it is nice to talk to Davinder and get first-hand information about the book. Can Bharadwaj, please tell me about your journey for this book, writing a history book where so many units are involved is not an easy task, sir. How have you been able to complete it in such a short period?
So to be very frank, the book came up as a challenge with the time limit we have, because any history book has to be researched in detail, and that requires about at least 4 to 5 years of effort. So luckily we had the handwritten notes of Major General Rao and Professor Swaminathan, who had written the first history book, that's the Tradition of Valor, Volume 1.
That's right.
So that became our base from which we could cover a lot of ground. And we already had a model to follow in the in terms of the Tradition of Valor, Volume 1. With the assistance of everyone and in the true Bombay Sapper way of doing things, we were able to manage just to cross the finishing line just in time.
I hope we'll be able to see it being released by the chief guest and most probably our Honorary Colonel Commandant General M.M. Naravane on 1st of February.
We're looking forward to that, sir.
Yeah. Tell me, when you wrote this book, how did you collect the data for this and the information?
Like I said, sir, initially we had the base with us. That's the notes of General Rao and Professor Swaminathan, who were the compilers of the first volume. Based on that, we went through the annual records of the units, the data which was there in the Mukut, and generally we were restricted to using data from open domain in terms of the policy on the subject, which was quite understandable. So we were guided by the existing guidelines in terms of what we can include, cannot include. We also included interactions with veterans, officers who had actually done those operations. We included some news articles from the internet also, which could verify certain facts. So it was by bits and pieces, joining things together, and the contribution of the unit, especially the commanding officers who we spoke to and got certain clarification from them. The major role, I think, was the veterans, who interacted very positively and were very forthcoming with the information, especially photographs and the details of their time in the unit. So that actually became a contribution from every aspect of the Bombay Sappers. So that was actually the thing which helped us take this thing ahead, and we were able to get the things together in time.
I see. Well, that's nice to hear that the veterans were supporting you in feeding information, because many times I have seen that some people don't share the information, and they are shy You know, Indians basically, I've seen, are very shy of writing and putting things on record. But it's good to hear that. Now, tell me, during this period, which was Bharadwaj? Since you have gone through the entire period from 1971 onwards, I would like to know from you as to which is the portion which you like the maximum.
So, to be very frank, it's very difficult to identify any specific unit as from that aspect, because every unit has the characteristics or that exposure or the operations which have highlighted the basic essence of the Bombay Sappers.
I agree.
From that point, maybe the units which are older, they're not as material in terms of units like 411 Parafield Company, which was one of the oldest units, and units which had gallantry honours like 110 Indian Regiment, 20 Field Company, and 21 Field Company of 102 Indian Regiment, where the gallantry awards and the honours and awards which the unit had, they made a lot of interesting reading.
Yes.
There were incidents like Secretary Lieutenant Sapotnekar, who sacrificed his life in a pretty daring operation. Other than that, even the routine happening in the unit, which were showcased the spirit of the Bombay Sapper in the unique way of doing things. So every chapter has got a uniqueness in itself. But then certainly I have something close to my heart, not because I'm a paratrooper, but if I were to see
prejudice
from the maroon eye, I think 411 was certainly a lot of interesting things which came up in terms of the history part.
Right, right. I remember Sapatnikar's sad end. It was a chance that he had to go to Kholia to make that rope bridge in Mizo Hills. The 113 was in Dimapur, and he was tasked to go there. He came to my unit to collect some stores. 106 Indian Regiment, where I was, my first regiment. And there he was going with the CO of the Infantry Battalion, and they were all ambushed. And he got the bust right in front in this thing. I also attended his funeral, cremation. Parents had come, his father was a brigadier for my education corps. Very sad day indeed. Nice to know that 411, actually, when I see the number of videos which have been done for the Bicentenary, is all red, red and red on top. I don't know how it is, coincidence. And you're also wearing the same.
It's just maroon. Just.
Not the red, but the maroon. Now, that is one aspect. Now tell me what difficulties you had, because you had a very tight schedule. You know, Bicentenary was coming, and you had to finish before that, because so that could be released by the chief guest. How did you, overcome that?
Our biggest strength was that we were organized well.
Yeah.
Secondly, we had a lot of support from the institution.
Yeah.
The contribution of each and every one, the premise of the book is that we don't have to highlight personalities. We have to highlight the events.
Yeah.
And it's got to be unbiased. Yeah. The directions given by the Colonel Commandant.
Yes.
And the involvement of everyone right from the Colonel Commandant onwards.
Yes.
It was a motivating thing for us when the curriculum plan himself went through every page of it and his set of corrections came in.
Yes.
It became a motivation for us to be more deliberate about things.
Yes.
More than that, the involvement of various aspects, various facets of the center where we required assistance in terms of information or administrative assistance, all that came so willingly and so smilingly. So it made up the entire journey quite easy.
Yeah.
At the end of it, any history book has to be about facts and figures.
Yes.
So those verification of those facts and figures, that was a bit of a challenge, because at times you had conflicting accounts about the same incident.
Yes.
So then we were we went by what was the thing which could be verified from the person who had actually been there.
Yeah. Bharadwaj, I tend to agree with you that at times we tend to, or we are inclined to highlight the personalities. I think you did a very wise thing
that you didn't give importance to personalities, but you gave importance to events. And those events would definitely motivate the future generations when they go through this book. I'm sure about it. Now, Bharadwaj, tell me, were you able to collect certain photographs and some other useful artifacts or something like that, which sort of made your book colorful?
So actually, we have included the photographs, and the biggest challenge in terms of the book was that the directions of the policy guidelines which are there, so they limit the narration of certain events and certain opportunities. So that takes away a lot of lot from the book as far as the operational aspect is concerned. So those guidelines have to be respected, and they have to be followed because of what they stand for in terms of the aspects of maintaining confidentiality about things. But then maintaining that and then still taking the flow along, that was the biggest challenge. But we were lucky that we had adequate number of photographs which depict the various aspects of operations of the center, activities of sports, adventure, aid to civil authority. So we covered them in terms of photographs also, and as part of the narrative also.
Bharadwaj, I'd like to know, you just mentioned about your terms of reference or directions. Was there any impediment in your working with the terms of reference which was imposed on you?
So, like I mentioned, operations is actually the sense of history book.
Yes.
The routine aspects we are quite used to.
Yeah.
And for a veteran to relate to routine aspects, you know, it doesn't really become a motivational factor even for a youngster to read about it. Operations are things which we all aspire for and we look forward to. And the directions on the policy guidelines on the operational details which could be included, could not be included, they have to be respected. So that was the only thing where we felt there was a the challenge which we felt. But otherwise, there are a lot of other events also which you mentioned in the book, which if you see, the book has been organized into chapters as per the units are concerned. So an officer who served, maybe we, as you were, we as sapper officers, you serve in a couple of units. And we have parent unit and the units you serve, so it can relate it to better, and the officer can read about his own unit, and it becomes an inspiration for him to see how the unit and how the history has flowed, and how he is lucky to learn from that, he or she is lucky to learn from that, and to contribute towards it, because for the further editions which come up and the next volume of the book when it comes up, so they are also a part of it. So that's been the essence behind it, sir.
Well, I think wonderful talking to you about your journey of writing this book, and I'm sure you'll write more, many more, not only on the army incidents and army books, but otherwise also, because it's a very good experience, and everybody doesn't have the experience. You see? So best of luck.
Thank you.
And
sir,
look forward to the release of the book by the chief.
Thank you, sir.
It was nice talking to you.
Pleasure.
And thank you on behalf of the Aviation Defense Universe.
Thank you, sir.
And look forward for many more glorious years in your life and many more promotions.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Yes, sir.